The veritable swing. Just move your head side to side. And notice the illusion of the pen appearing to move in the opposite direction you swing to. That's called the swing of oppositional movement. This is the veritable swing. You see later in the video, you can do it on the side too. I like the center best. Don't look at the pen, don't look at the far. Just sweep across. Don't try to see anything, just blink. I made you a PDF. This is Dr. Bates from his Better Eyesight magazines. This is one of his stories of a lady that was cured of unclear vision. Here's the original text teaching you how to do it. And I've added a little bit here. We can enlarge it. The veritable swing helps to cure astigmatism and conical cornea. So I've thrown in some articles on that. Here's your swing again with more directions. He's shifting on the chair in the eye chart. He's also swinging side to side and watching the chair and chart appear to move in opposite directions against each other. The chair appears to move opposite his movement. Chair will go here. Chair will go here. The eye chart appears to move with him, though in reality it is moving against him, but it's just so much less compared to the chair that it appears to move with him. But it does show an opposite swing if you watch for it. Here we're doing the veritable again. Pen between the eyes, central field. Then you can try to sway as he's doing in front of the objects and watch objects at different distances, observe their movement as you just sweep across. You should always move your head with your eyes when you're looking at something. I'm looking at this side of the chart. Then I move to this side, this side, this side. But see, if I try to do it when I'm doing this, it's hard. It's not normal vision. So, what you want to do, you can do the long swing and see things move opposite without stopping to look at anything. Like, don't stop like this. Then you can shorten it to the sway. Right now I'm just sweeping across the far. I'm sweeping across the close. I'm not looking at anything. I'm just blinking and sweeping. Then you shorten the sway. And when you get to those tiny short ones, you can just move around and you can shift on a letter. See how my head's moving with my eyes? I got a tiny little sway. I'm looking at this side of the chart, then this. This and this. The V. Point to point. One side to the other. My head movement is no longer than the shift of my eyes when I'm shifting on something. From one point to another, the chair. You see oppositional movement when you move up and down. Diagonally. It moves in the opposite direction your eyes shift to. So you can read about that. See what else we have. I threw in a few examples. Here's the central field one. Here's to the side, central field. Keep it centered. Just relax when you do it. To the side. Enough so you can see it. You don't want to be, don't look like this. Just look straight ahead. You can see the pen appear to move. I don't know why they teach it like this too. It might be to test your peripheral vision. But if you practice central vision, it automatically improves your peripheral, nice and clear too. I'm looking at the pan, I shouldn't be doing that. Go like that. Just sweep over it. Don't even stop to look at it. I find it easier sometimes to just sweep over the distance. If I sweep over the close, I start looking at the pen. It's easier just to sweep over nothing or the distance. So I just showed you how to do it wrong and how to do it right. Okay. This guy's doing the long swing. I showed you this before. I can't fit in here. Still working on a better arrangement for my office for you guys. So here we have all the different swings. Dr. Bates listed the short swing, universal. You can read about that, memory. Here's your variable, what we were just doing. Long swing, drifting. More swinging. Here you go again. So he describes them a few different ways. Make sure you understand it. Here's some examples of patients cured by doing the swinging and the shifting. Swaying. You can shorten it and shift on a letter on the eye chart. That's a tiny letter. Astigmatism. This helps to cure, get rid of astigmatism. The best way to start is take that astigmatism prescription out of your eyeglasses. If you have to wear glasses for driving and safety, get reduced, weaker glasses that still enable you to drive and work safely, legally. Strong glasses and glasses with astigmatism prescription in it cause an increase astigmatism, blur, and lead to other eye problems. So you want to learn how to reduce your prescription, preferably just, if you can do it, completely take away all the eyeglass prescription, take away the astigmatism and the eyeglass prescription. Don't wear glasses. If you have to wear glasses, get a weaker prescription. And if you have to have some astigmatism in the glasses, which I prefer you don't, because that's going to hold you back on your improvement. But if you have to, take the numbers that's in your prescription for the astigmatism and reduce it weaker. And just an extra quick note here, I'm tacking on the video. You can go on the website to learn how to reduce your eyeglass prescription weaker and weaker and weaker until you're totally free of eyeglasses and you don't have to wear any eyeglasses. Go to your eye doctor, go to your RMV, DMV for your driver's test and pass it without glasses. And just so I can repeat, keeping that astigmatism prescription in the eyeglasses, it maintains and increases the astigmatism and usually ends up with stronger and stronger astigmatism prescriptions. That's one thing that leads to that conical cornea where the cornea bulges and ulcers. So don't wear glasses, please. I guess if you have to go to work, you have to wear glasses to drive, then try the reduced astigmatism prescription. Reduce it, reduce it, reduce it until you can legally and safely see through plain eyeglasses. It also reduces the eyeglass, the overall prescription itself too. And as soon as you can see without glasses, don't wear them. And at least you'll be going down instead of going up into stronger lenses. Thanks for watching, and watch for our next video. Warning against the dangers of the harmful cataract detached retina producing plus lens anti-corrective method. It's a very unhealthy, unnatural method a lot of people are advising. I suspect a lot of these people secretly sell eyeglasses and link to eye surgeons that sell LASIK and cataract surgery, the two things that this unnatural method causes. So watch for that video. I'm trying to get it done. I hate doing it. I don't wear glasses. I don't like talking about glasses. But this is something that has to be done. They're advising it to children, pilots, everybody. A lot of people get an impaired vision from it. It involves wearing reading glasses, even when your vision's clear. Natural eyesight improvement teachers teach you not to wear glasses. Or if you have, say, myopia or presbyopia, whichever glasses your doctor gives you for that, you just go weaker and weaker. These people who are selling the unnatural method want you to go stronger and stronger. Okay, so that's all for today. Check us out on the guest page, and I'll post this video for 4 students and also on the website for the 2 other students. We get a lot of astigmatism people. Another thing I wanted to say is those eye test machines and being nervous in the doctor's office, that can cause a temporary astigmatism that you normally wouldn't have. And it seems almost everybody, when you go to the doctor, almost all the doctors want to put astigmatism prescription in the eyeglasses. Putting that in for a temporary tiny astigmatism that might occur while you're trying to look through that machine with your neck all tight and your movement limited goes away when you leave the doctor's office, but then you're stuck with that astigmatism prescription in the glasses. And that's the main thing that causes astigmatism. It makes it remain, becomes stronger. You need stronger lenses. It increases the astigmatism. And you can see all that in our videos. We have 2 other astigmatism videos on YouTube. Thank you. The veritable swing. Don't stare at the finger, don't stare at the distance, just move your head side to side, nice and relaxed. Your eyes move with your head in the same direction. You'll notice that the finger moves in the opposite direction that your head and eyes move to. When I move this way, my finger looks like it's moving that way. When I move this way, my finger looks like it's moving that way. So just allow that nice, relaxed movement to happen. And see the finger go like that. It loosens up your neck. But it also gets your eyes moving. Loosens up all the tension. If you look at 2 objects at different distances, say my finger and a distant tree, and you move like this without moving my finger, let me try this. I really should have put something here to hang, but just say my whole body's moving side to side without this moving. Stationary objects will appear to move opposite the movement of your eyes, head, and body. Close and distant objects in middle of they'll appear to move against each other. Close objects move against the direction you're moving in. The most, middle, a little less, and far shows the least oppositional movement. It's an illusion, an appearance of opposite movement. If your vision is very, very unclear and you want to move, if you move like this, you're going to see the objects appear to move against each other. And that helps you distinguish between 2 different objects in different distances. If your vision is so unclear without glasses that you can't tell what object is like a tree from a bush at 2 different distances, when you move, those objects at different distances are going to start moving against each other. And you're going to start to be able to distinguish one object from another. Even if it's one piece of blur from another, you'll be able to start to tell that they're 2 different objects. That helps you with your central fixation, centralizing, looking at and shifting upon one object at a time, as opposed to staring and trying, without moving, and trying to see everything all at once, trying to figure out what an object is. Move upon it. Find out where the object is with your opposite movement. And then you're narrowing down to get that where you're looking is moving on the object. Instead of trying to see all of this at once, you're seeing one part at a time. But you see, your peripheral picks everything up too and goes to your brain, but the clearest area of your visual field is in the center, and that's moving on the object you want to see. And you can do that even on tiny objects. And that's in our other videos. So let's use a nice... You can also do the variable swing on the side. And you can see the pen appear to move in the opposite direction of the face. You don't have to go too fast. And do the other side too. Don't stop and stare at anything, just relax. You see the pen move opposite your face. When I'm going this way, it appears to go this way. When I'm going this way, it appears to go this way. It's like that, but it's stationary. The pen is actually stationary. It's just an illusion. It's relaxing. It loosens up your eye movement. It gets your neck relaxed. I need that today. I've been typing too much. This helps. You can do the figure eight to loosen everything up too. This helps cure conical cornea and astigmatism. I'm posting this for a student that's looking to cure those things. And read up on astigmatism. I'll write it on the guest page. Just check for astigmatism and conical cornea in Dr. Bates' Better Eyesight magazines. I forget what they call it nowadays. It's like a cornea. It can turn into a cornea ulcer or scar where your cornea sticks out. It can turn into an ulcer or a scar. Staying away from glasses, learning the Bates method of relaxation, blink and shift when you want to see something. Gets those eye muscles to stop being tense. The eye goes nice and round. That cornea goes nice and round. You get rid of that conical cornea. Let's see. Neck tension is a major cause of astigmatism and eye muscle tension. Read about on our website. We have a PDF about violinists who develop such twisted and crooked postures of the eyes, neck, and shoulders. It gets certain eye muscles. Your neck nerves in your neck go up and it goes into the eye muscles. And certain eye muscles get tight, press on the eye, make it abnormal shape. And that's what causes the astigmatism. When the eye's abnormal shape, the cornea is too. So you correct your posture, relax, and use natural eyesight improvement. And you get rid of that astigmatism and anything else that it leads to. You reverse everything to natural.